Pedro Ruiz, and my dream is to become a firefighter.
My name is Samantha Abundance, and my dream is to become a marine biologist.
My name is Brittany Stewart, and my dream is to become a psychologist.
My name is Aziza Vaughn, and my dream is to become a registered nurse.
My name is Arlene Cerrato, and I want to be a teacher and a singer.
When the night has come.
In 1981, businessman Gene Lang returned to the elementary school he had attended 50 years earlier to give a speech to a class of graduating sixth graders. He intended to tell them, "Work hard and you'll succeed," but on the way to the podium, PS 121's principal told Lang that 3/4 of the school's students would probably never finish high school, prompting Lang to make an extraordinary impromptu change to his speech. He promised college tuition to every sixth grader who stayed in high school and graduated. From this promise, the I Have a Dream Foundation was born.
The thing that makes I Have a Dream different is that it is a long-term program. The problems, the situations that are keeping our children from succeeding did not develop overnight, and they are not going to be resolved overnight. It takes years. And when we start working with the children very young, and we bond with them and we get to be really close to them, then we can have hopes of influencing them as they make decisions, and we're with them day by day.
What iDream is trying to do is move these kids through education out of poverty and into a better life. In Los Angeles alone, in the areas that we go and adopt children, maybe 30% of the kids graduate from high school. We have been able to turn that around. Depending on the class, 80-90% of our children graduate from high school, and it's an amazing success.
Just looking at the numbers, just looking at the percentage of blacks and Latinos graduating from high school in these neighborhoods kind of tells all. And with the I Have a Dream Foundation, it really creates the expectation, creates the desire for these kids to go through the process and get their degree. And when we started, it was dismal as to what was expected for Linwood Carr. He was said to be a lost cause and basically someone who wasn't going to graduate from high school. And it's been a huge turnaround.
All I knew was the inner city. Here's my school. My parents work a regular job, living paycheck to paycheck. And I actually didn't think of college. They started to talk about college more and more and prepare us. And by the time I got to high school, I said, "Oh my God, I'm going to college." When I was in college, and it was hard. But the both of us was up at night studying. She was an infant, she's crying, I'm doing the books, but I was very determined. And one is because I knew I have a dream on my back, and I knew I could get it finished.
Sometimes in our lives, we are.